I also want to ask you about the gallery system. This is something that today all artists engage with. It's a space of quite necessary for many artists. But in India, the gallery system has evolved slowly over a period of time. And for many, initially, and I'm therefore interested in the period of time when you were a young artist, I know that that many of the pioneer galleries like Black Partridge, it wasn't even Art Heritage in those days, so Mr. and Mrs. Alkazi or Mr. Pandol, Keku Gandhi and Khurshed, these were people who had very endearing relationships with the art community. They were people who were not just supporters of the art community, they were friends, you know, people who were involved with discourse. So that is an area that I'm interested in. As well as how you as a young artist or as an artist later on in your career, were you somebody who believed in the gallery system, who desired to engage with it? What are these, what is this territory for you?
I have no idea, no, how the works of earlier artists, that's, you know, Nandlal Bose and Avanindranath and were exhibited. You know. I think there were certain societies, because the Bombay Art Society is one of the older societies. There was also in Mumbai another society, you know. Like in Delhi they have All India Fine Arts and Craft Society. So these institutions were having galleries and probably organizing annual shows, and people were participating. I think system of showing solo shows was probably not there then, but I do not really know. When I was student here, we had seen exhibition of Hussain's exhibited in museum, Baroda Museum. So it should be something like this, no? That and Jahangir Art Gallery was started in 1952. And, since then, Bombay Art Society started having its annual shows in gallery, because that gallery was built for this. Then they, I think, introduced this system that people can rent it, no artist. And in a way, it was good that whoever wanted to show his work could rent the gallery. Eventually, demand increased, and I think they started some system where a committee would select your work and approve whether to show or not, which was, I think, very good, because it allowed people to show their work. And it was not like in other countries where unless you get gallery, you never get chance to show. Now, when I was in New York, that's early 60s, I was told that there were more than 60,000 practicing artists living in New York City only. And maybe there were 2,000-3,000 who had opportunity of showing their work in gallery. You know, others were just working. So that way in India it was, when it started, it was much better, no, that people could show.
Yes.
But then galleries also, I think Kemold Gallery came up more or less within few years after Jahangir Art Gallery. Pandol also probably more or less same time. No. But then they selected certain artists. It was not that way, that democratic. No, that.
Sure.
And as a student, we had... after completing 3 years, our college had first one-man show. No? Or not, I mean, the show,
yes,
in a, on a very large scale,
yes,
showing what we were doing here.
Yes.
And
yes,
that made it, it worked very well for our faculty. No? Then people knew more. They even had a printed catalog. Printing catalog was again a very new thing, you know.
This was all of the staff or of the students?
No, no, all the students, right? I mean, from first year to fourth year. We had completed 3 years, but we had some students who had come from Kalabhavan, so they were in final year. So then when we completed our 6 years first time, Shanti Dave and Santosh wanted to show their work, you know, as a kind of a solo show, or if two people are, what is it called, dual show, whatever.
Yeah.
Bendre Sahib didn't allow us to show our work when we were students. You know. He said that, didn't allow means Bombay Art Society, you know, in their annuals, they had a student category.
Mm-hmm.
But Bendre Sahib discouraged them, okay. Unless you are artist, no, don't show it. No. Otherwise, it can maybe create some problem, no, psychological with some mm-hmm. students, which I noticed later that it did.
Yes.
So Bendre Sahib said, showing is nice, but why do you want to show only two? Why don't you have a group and no, show all of you?
Mm-hmm.
So that's how the our group came up, no, and it was called Baroda Group. How this Baroda school term eventually started, this confusion, because we were calling Baroda group. There was no ideology, but whoever was from here. So show of maybe 15 people, no, and not only us who had completed 6 years, but whoever was doing good work. No, I mean, selection names were suggested by Bendre Sahib, but. So Sheikh and Vinod Rai Patel and Kanaria and who were in second year, third year then.
Right.
And we were collecting 10 rupees per work. From so if there were 60 works, we would have 600 rupees to manage.
Mm-hmm.
That would for packing, taking works, two people would go stay somewhere in some cheap dharmsala or somewhere, or some with friend.
And it was going to be in Delhi or Bombay?
Bombay.
Okay.
So we did 3 or 4 regular shows, no, annually. Okay. It was called Baroda Group, okay. And like that. And people were like Ara and Pilu Pochkanwala, and they were excited.
Mm-hmm.
They would encourage, tell us how to hang, where to hang. They would even get people from newspaper or some company of Tata's or some,
yes,
because
yes.
Pilu was Parsi and she had this to print our reproductions and so eventually our works were purchased by Air India and they published it in their calendars and like that, they were all very helpful. But after that I had only one personal show, when I had rented the gallery, and I realized that it was too much of a hassle, taking a show and then sitting there like a vendor who sits on street.
Mm-hmm.
Though I did that for Baroda's group, all the time.
Mm.
But doing it for myself was difficult, so that's the only show I did.
Mm.
And eventually whoever approached me, so I did 2 or 3 shows with Kemold, 2 or 3 shows with Art Heritage,
right.
Sim Rosa, and so on. But I never got connected or contracted any gallery.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Al-Ghazi was a good, became good friend, because earlier when they started that gallery, Black Partridge.
That's right, yes.
He had invited me, and then I had suggested that there were lots of young, because I had already become teacher by then, so I said, those who were doing good work in students, and they said, you should see their work. And he agreed, and he gave them shows, that Vinod Dave, I don't know if you
know.
Who had now, who
is in America.
And, but then he even invited me for my photographs, and that's how I got little interested in my own photographic work, when I had suggested him, when he said that you will not be able to sell any work, because nobody buys photograph. And he said he was not interested in selling, mainly. I mean, he wanted to show work. So that encouraged me, and so I had 2-3 shows later, with Mr. Al-Ghazi. photographs mainly, but he also had shown my prints.
Yes.
But I also found that when this gallery became business, I realized two things, that people like Alkazi or Mrs. Godrej,
yes,
for whom gallery was not their bread and butter, I mean, if I use that term. Manisab hates that term, no? Bread and butter. But that's the part of language. So then they were not that keen on selling, you know. And as a result, they wouldn't do
much
other things that would go with it, you know. They didn't care. If somebody bought it, fine.
Yes.
If somebody wrote it, fine. I mean, no. The way in other countries I had noticed, no, that gallery, the writer,
yes,
magazine, they were, and artists, they were all dependent on each other, no? Promoting artists would also promote all the other three,
absolutely,
and like that.
Absolutely.
It was not here, no?
Yes.
So then, and when people realized that because of this so-called art boom, so many galleries came up, and then they were not honest, no? I mean, it's very difficult for us to keep that kind of a legal contract and everything, and even if it is possible, it's a hassle.
Yes.
This is another thing I learned from my father. No? He always used bicycle, no? Till 85 or so, and when doctors told him that it was, he was stopped by force, no? And that gap in bicycle,
yes,
between gear and upper road, triangle,
yes,
he had a board with message. And one thing that he says, never go to court. You will ruin your life. Something like this. He had all this throughout. No? He had message written on his back also, shirt. So that also, and then somebody also told me that when Gandhiji wrote this, his first, when he returned from England to, you know, that in 10 days he had written Hind Swaraj. I mean, it was written in Gujarati first.
Yes.
And in Hind Swaraj he has written very clearly that two people have ruined this country, you know, lawyers and doctors, medical doctors.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the whole system. So, I realized that, you know, though you have right, you can't normally win, you know,
true,
legally, because,
true, true.
I mean, you can't go to Delhi if there is a court for one painting,
sure,
and that time it was, you know, 100 rupees, 200 rupees. In fact, one magazine, Yatrik, you know, which was the Government of India publication, ITDC, they had printed my photograph. I never knew, but somebody showed me. So I wrote to them that it was nice that they printed and had even given me credit. But no,
the copyright belongs to you. Absolutely.
Just so, if you have any standard remuneration,
you should pay.
Should I not get it?
Absolutely.
I'm just like that.
Yes.
So they said yes. They sent me a contract that I had to prove that it is mine. If anybody, even in later, if anybody claimed that it was not my work and it was his or her work, I will have to fight on behalf of ITDC to this. So I said, sorry, when I am unable to fight for my own right,
yes,
I can't afford to fight for you.
Sure.
No.
Sure.
So I said, I am ready to let go my whatever 100 rupees or that you are giving. Forget it.
Yes, yes.
So this happens, no? And I found that some galleries have, no, they take away your work, they never reply.
Yes.
Then I just give up. I mean, so-called blacklist, no, for myself. In fact, in my address diary, there are some, you know, danger. I have made skull and just so that I don't. But this happened, no? That one gallery who very recommended by many of, because she was an artist herself and she started a gallery. She took away about 6-5 work, never paid me. When I said, she said she didn't know how to pay. I said there are several methods. Now you can write check, you can send draft, you can edit in my money order. Or she replied, I'm waiting. Then her daughter was a student here. And when she completed, she sent to take more work. And there's no hope. I mean, the young girl coming to me asking that my mother wants your work. And I couldn't say no. I gave 2 or 3 more.
Oh, my
God. So this happens.